Now, Mount Hutt is one of the South Island's most popular ski fields, and it's just turned 50.
So over the weekend, New Zealand Ski put on a three-day hootenanny in Methven. Julian Lee went along.
The entirety of Methven, and then some, must be here tonight. A blizzard of festivity has descended on this mid-Canterbury town. It's the first night of a three-day party due to go all weekend.
I guess you don't turn 50 every day, so 50 years young, great to celebrate.
It's impossible to imagine Methven without all the snow, bucks and bunnies, but it wasn't always this way.
The road's ashbrit, not even tar seal when I come here.
Really?
Yeah.
And was it a very small town?
It was a very small town, yeah.
Just like the
butcher shop, a dairy and a couple of churches, and that was all.
A pretty standard mid-Canterbury town, I guess, a service town.
Oh, yes. Just about dead.
This is a celebration of a ski field that changed the town for good. But in another way, this is all about a road. The road up to Mount Hutt, a Lions Club project, 1973. Controversial at the time, expensive, a gamble.
I was designated to put the track in.
There were people at the time that said it couldn't be done, right?
Oh, there was a few about.
Lots of people told me, it's impossible, you can't put a road up there. And he thought, well, I could put a road anywhere. Did you know how to do that sort of thing?
Oh, no. I started driving the bulldozer during the school holidays when the operator took his holidays.
You wouldn't get away with something like that today.
You have no show.
A lot of people were very doubtful about it, but now there's thousands, hundreds of thousands go up there every year.
If the ski field wasn't here, yep, sure, Methven would still be here. It's a rural town. It still has a really strong rural background, and it's a service town to that part of the community. It would be a different town.
Town that now has the wherewithal to host none other than Dragon, which has also just turned 50. The villagers have put them in the local civil defence bus out the back of the Blue Pub where we find them.
Are you guys going to have a rock and roll night tonight?
Absolutely. When do we not have a rock and roll night?
That's a good job description.
Yeah, are you going to be, throwing TVs out of windows and that sort of thing?
Mate, I'll be doing snow angels up at the chairlifts.
What are we going to hear tonight?
Rain.
Yeah.
Rain.
Horses.
Rain. I think.
Rain.
About 25 minutes of rain.
And some jazz. We'll do jazz.
Gonna sit down and talk to myself.
Are there any particular songs you want to hear tonight?
Rain, definitely.
Rain, yeah.
Yeah. And April Sun.
The teenagers know your songs.
It's incredible.
Do you actually know Dragon?
Yeah, we met them today.
Their own band, Goodbye Thursday, from Mount Hutt College, this year's Rock Quest finalists, opened for Dragon earlier that day up the mountain.
We play April Sun and Cuba a lot in our band.
Is unusual feeling being the sort of, I guess it's the inheritors or the continuation, the living organism that is Dragon, you know?
The three of us have been 18 years, I think, and it's just... I don't know. To me, this is the Dragon that I think of now. I'm just like, this is what it is.
Are you kicking on with us later tonight?
Am I invited?
Yeah.
Excellent. Yeah. That's not just a TV thing?
It's just a TV thing, though.
No, yeah. I'll definitely come.
Did you ever envisage back then anything like this looking around here right
now? No.
And you've got one of the biggest rock bands from Australasia performing Methven in mid-Canterbury.
Mid-Canterbury, yeah. And look at the weather. I call this the centre of the universe here. Everybody's coming here to live now.
A town with a snowballing population, a brave community who took a free ride 50 years ago, dodged a couple of trees and cliffs along the way, and now truly having a great run.